on a snow-covered Ball State University campus. Today, Ball State hosts Eastern Michigan and Illinois State in a late January tri-meet. College gymnastics, and it's next on ESPN3. Welcome inside the new home of Ball State Gymnastics, Worthen Arena. Eastern Michigan and Illinois State are in town for today's tri-meet. Hello, everybody. Alongside Morgan Landis and former Ball State gymnast Brooklyn Schumacher, Tyler Bradfield on hand. Brooklyn, from a standout on the bars last season, Illinois State in town, a team on the rise. Who do you have your eye on?
I have my eye today on Dancy Cha. She's on three events today, and normally she's on all four, but she came out in their first meet against Air Force with all four events. I've got my eyes on her today.
On the other hand, for Eastern Michigan, Kendall Valentin has great presence out on the floor. She was an All-MAC gymnast on January 12th, so she was the gymnast of the week, so she will have all the eyes here tonight.
And for Ball State, your former teammate, Denasia Christian.
Denasia Christian is Ball State University's gymnastics star. She came out on three events this season and has potential to medal on all three at the MAC. She's the defending MAC champion on floor and the current MAC gymnast of the week.
A look at our impact gymnasts tonight. Rotation one is coming up next. This is College Gymnastics on ESPN3.
Seconds.
Star Wars.
Can you
guys hear me? Star Wars. That's what that is.
Ready?
I just let everyone down on that one. Star Wars.
Hey, Cardinal Gym fans, our first event is vault. Now, each gymnast only gets to do one vault. So here's what to look for. Entrance.
4 minute touch period underway for rotation one, Ball State, Eastern Michigan, and Illinois State in today's tri meet.
And of course, a step
lead. Let's take a look at the head coaches. First off, for Ball State in her second season, Joanna Salim, last year finished fifth place at the 2014 MAC Championships, the highest for Ball State since 2011. Joanna Salim, the head coach for Ball State. On the other hand, Eastern Michigan, Joe Santos, in just his second season, was the 2015 MAC Coach of the Year. Really turned things around for Eastern Michigan's program. Put up a mark of 13-5 on his overall record, tying the team record for most regular season wins in just his first season, Jay Santos for Eastern Michigan. And then Bob Conkling for Illinois State in his 11th season. For the Redbirds, a graduate of Indiana Wesleyan, where he coached swimming and gymnastics as a student while receiving credit. He's been coaching gymnastics since he was 15 years old, the head coach for Illinois State.
Our first rotation today, we'll have Ball State on the ball.
Looking at the rotation lineups, with Ball State starting out on vault, Eastern Michigan on the bars, and Illinois State on the beam. Ball State leads off with Shelby Arms, a junior. Jordan Penny on Friday at Illinois State had a team high 9.750. She's fourth on the lineup for vault for Ball State.
Now, Shelby Arms with Ball State University is proving to be really useful on the vault this year, as there's been a rule change with the NCAA. Different vaults that used to be worth a 10-0 start value are no longer. So that has made Ball State University have one 10-0 start value, and that's Shelby Arms today. We're going to see her warm up here.
And on the bars for Eastern Michigan, as we start off with vault for Ball State, Shelby Arms.
First on the bars for Eastern Michigan will be Sydney McEcker.
Sydney McEcker on the bars for Eastern Michigan.
Really nice form here so far, and a strong catch. You'll notice her lines are just beautiful in this bar routine so far. Really strong cast, really sure of herself. She's not letting the judges take anything in her cast, which is an easy place. And a stuck landing. That's a great start for the Eagles. That's going to be a great score.
Sydney McEachern also had 17 top 10 finishes last year, so she has proven her place here for Eastern Michigan.
Next on the ball for Ball State is Jayla Washington.
We return to the vault with Jayla Washington.
Jayla serves as a captain of this team.
And next on the beam for Illinois
She's
State.
She's proving to be really great on the vault as well, following Shelby Arms. She competes a Yurchenko half, and that's a 9-9 start value this year. Used to be 10-0 start value, but it doesn't take away from the strong vault that she brings to this team.
Shelby Arms in the first vault, a 9.80.
That's an incredible score for the first person in the lineup.
Washington from Carmel High School.
A great finish there for Jayla. Took a little bit of a step there out of her vault, landed a little bit in a squat. But she is really happy with that vault, as you can see. And that takes a lot with the judges. They like to see a happy gymnast at the end. Now a straddle back here for the Eagles. You don't see very many of those anymore. Missed that cast a little bit, but bringing it right back. Lots of turns here, lots of pirouettes. And a beautiful dismount. Wow, look at that. And the team is just ecstatic with that routine.
That's Gendron on the bars for Eastern Michigan. McEachern led off with a 9.725 on the bars for Eastern.
Now Claire Collins coming up on the vault is a sophomore, and she was actually out last season with foot reconstruction. She had to have two separate surgeries on her foot, have some hardware put in as well as taken out. And she was pretty close to coming back last season and has really come back strong after a summer of working out and is coming back on powerful events this season, floor and vault.
Always try to progress back into lineup spots, according to Salim, the head coach of Ball State.
So you're getting ready to go for a strong vault here. Wow. Chest a little low in that landing, but look at that. That is an incredible vault. And a full, a Yurchenko full that she just performed last year was a 10-0 star value and is no longer.
Next on the bars for Eastern Michigan is Lacey.
But that's still going to be a great score. She brings her chest right back up there at the end, which is exactly what the judges want to see.
Illinois State with a try meet competing on beams to start off. All three teams working in Olympic order. With vault bars being floor. However, for Eastern and Illinois State, they start out of order.
Next on the vault for Ball State is Jordan.
Now, after a gymnast falls, they have 30 seconds to get back up on the beam. And some are going to opt to go get some chalk. Some are going to opt to try and get their mind back together. And she seems confident here. Right back up on the beam. The backhand spring full and a half dismount. Jordan Penny coming up next on the vault is also a sophomore. She was the powerhouse freshman last year. She had a serious back injury, but the way that she has come back so far, as well as her performance last year, has been something to watch here for the Cardinals. She is an incredible, incredible gymnast. She's going to be performing your Yurchenko full. Jordan is known for her focus as she stands there right at the beginning of the vault runway. And she performs a tuck. So she must not have felt confident in that run, but she still went for it. Now, one thing that's important to note with NCAA gymnastics, each team on the vault has the chance to perform their vault three times. They have three chances to perform their one vault. So if she had opted to run to the side, that would have been fine. Shaposhnikova.
We return to the bars with Gervais of Eastern Michigan.
Great lines. And a beautiful dismount.
You know, Gervais, early on this week, we had a chance to talk to Jay Santos, which is Eastern Michigan's coach. She completely changed her routine this year, and it's still in a work in progress, but that looked excellent. So it looks like her work in progress is definitely taking a toll for the better.
Back on vault with Sarah Ebyer out of Whiteland, Indiana. Her sister here today competing for Eastern Michigan, Kimberly Ebyer.
And we see Sarah kind of dancing to the music, getting loose, ready for her vault.
Next on the vault for Ball State is Sarah Ebyer.
Her younger sister Kimberly will also compete on the vault beam and floor today.
That landing a little bit. When you're as powerful as Sarah Ebyer is, she's got to control her landings like that, and that's very hard when you have as much talent and as much power as
next
she has going into that entry.
You'll
notice she's just cascading forward. Still a safe landing, though.
Valentin on the bars. Morgan, your impact gymnast to watch.
Yeah, I mean, we talked to the coach, like I said, Jay Santos, and he said she just has great presence, comes out here, has excellent execution, and is one of the best definitely on bars and on the team as a whole.
Wow. Now, to do a dismount like that, her giants have to be perfect. She is swinging in a way that most gymnasts don't. She has an uncommon kind of swing, which allows her to do an incredible dismount like that.
This is the anchor on vault for Ball State, Danasia Christian.
Danasia is serving as the anchor on the three events that she performs today, which is incredibly uncommon. But with talent level like she has, it's a given.
The MAC Gymnast of the Week in January 19th.
And a beautiful vault from Christian. And look at that. She is absolutely thrilled with that vault.
Danasia Christian is an excellent vaulter. Last year, she had five first place finishes on vault, so that just proves her place.
Now, Dinesha is another one just like Sarah, who with as much power as she has going into that vault, she has to work really hard to try and control that landing and not continue to cascade forward. She works on the in the gym a lot with 8-inch mats stacked so that she doesn't do that.
This is Katie Conrad for Eastern Michigan on the bars.
The hecked mount and a great cast. Beautiful.
Valentin set the tone for her with a 9.80, the routine before.
An excellent form in that double layout dismount. And the team looks very happy with their bar performance so far.
Conrad really exploded this summer for Eastern Michigan between her freshman and sophomore year because of the work she put in over the summer in the gym. This is an exhibition routine for Ball State with Minzioni, a freshman on vault.
Very nice. Now, Minzioni is another Ball State gymnast that I think we should be watching, as she has the potential to perform on all four events. Bringing in a freshman like that is very valuable to any team, as she can come in at a moment's notice if the Cardinals need someone. She has a routine prepared on all four events.
On the bars for Eastern Michigan in an exhibition.
This is Dancy Shaw of Illinois State on the beam.
She looks very confident in her dance. Look at that. And that's what the judges are really looking for, is the confidence to do dance and skills like that without even batting an eye.
Nancy, one of six children.
Getting right back up on the beam. She does not even look phased. It's a really strong gymnast right there.
The first couple of years, Dancy Shaw was a gymnast for Illinois State. She primarily competed on beam only, so she's had a lot of practice, a lot of times where she, you know, can perfect certain things on the beam.
A really uncommon dismount there that she seems to have mastered. Now, coaches will choose gymnasts to put in an exhibition spot, more or less to see how they do in a situation like that, in a high-stress situation. They'll also try to see how the judges view their routine, how they're going to score it. That's a really valuable position to be able to test your athletes out in.
Last on the beam for Illinois State will be Amanda.
Notice Coach Salim often puts gymnasts who are freshmen into exhibition spots to test their confidence and build it so that she doesn't have to put someone in blind and wonder how they're going to do.
That's Jay Santos, the head coach of Eastern Michigan. A cap on rotation one with Ball State on the vault, Eastern Michigan the bars, and Illinois State on the beam. Good, half a step back. You can let the pictures breathe a little. through rotation one in Worthen Arena. Ball State competed on the vault, Eastern Michigan on the bars, Illinois State on the beam. As we prepare for rotation two, Morgan Landis caught up with the head coach of Eastern Michigan, Jay Santos, earlier today.
Thanks, Tyler. Coach, last year you had an excellent season, really came in strong. How did you kind of set the standards for this year, and what are some of your goals for this season?
The standards are the same we had last year. For us, it's all about, you know, just making improvements and keep continuing to make those improvements so we can raise the level and the, you know, the culture of the program. We've talked about a lot of different things this year. I mean, making regionals is obviously one of the main goals that we have. That's never happened in the program's history before. Individuals have made it, but not as a team. So, I mean, that would say that's our main goal. And from there, you know, we've got a bunch of, you know, we'd like to be undefeated at home. And,
right,
you know,
yeah,
some of the smaller goals that will get us to those steps along the way. But the main goal would be to qualify the team to regionals.
Kendall Valentin, a very strong, powerful person for you on your team. What do you expect to see from her today?
I hope and expect to see the same thing she's done the first 2 weeks. She had a great preseason. You know, her body's feeling good. Everything's feeling really, you know, strong this year. She had a little bit of an ankle issue last year that really slowed her down. So that we've pretty much, you know, got that under wraps. So, you know, we hope. And, you know, she's been right on point for the first two meets, looking very confident, looking very, you know, very comfortable. So I'm hoping to see the same thing.
All right, thanks, Coach. Thanks so much for your time, and good luck in today's tri meet.
Thank you.
Great stuff as always, Morgan. As we prepare for rotation two, we take a look back at rotation one. Illinois State starting out on the beam.
A really strong back handspring layout there. An aerial back full. One thing about the Illinois State Redbirds is they have some really unusual dismounts that they have really mastered.
Eastern Michigan was on the bars with a score of 48.80.
They had some really strong dismounts today. They must have been really working on their stick landings.
And Ball State on vault with a 48.2.
That's an excellent score for the Cardinals. A surprise there from Jordan Penny, but with the Cardinals and every team here being able to drop one score out of six, that was not a problem for them today.
The scores from Ball State's results on vault in rotation one. The highest score from Denisha Christian with a 9.80, but a good score for Ball State with a 48.2, Brooklyn.
Absolutely. That's exactly what the Cardinals want to start off this meet.
The results from Eastern Michigan on the bars, with Eastern Michigan with a 48.80.
That's a very high score as well for the Eagles. A goal for most teams is going to be in the 49s. If they get in the 49s, that means they averaged a little bit higher than a 9.75. And that's a goal for gymnastics teams here in the MAC.
And with Illinois State on the beam during rotation one, Coach Conkling said this could be their best event if they could just hit. But they lost their best beam worker from last season due to graduation. This is Illinois State's results from that beam. The team score of 47.925. In third place to Ball State and Eastern Michigan. Rotation two, Ball State on the bars, Eastern Michigan on the beam, Illinois State on the floor. Brooklyn, all three teams competing in Olympic order. But every gymnast thinks vault, bars, beam, floor. But when you start out of order, does that throw anything off mentally?
No, generally not, as these gymnasts have been doing this sport since they were really, really young. They're used to, they can just be thrown in at any point, and they're going to be mentally just fine. That's what their coaches have trained them to do since day one.
Eastern Michigan on the beam with their lineup, an event where they're 11th in the country currently, as certainly a strong event for them. Leading off with Kimberly Ebyer, the sister to Sarah Ebyer of Ball State.
Now, the Ball State Cardinals have joked with each other about trying to take Kimberly Evire so they have both sisters. So we might see if they're able to snatch her after this meet and keep her here.
Illinois State on the floor here in rotation two. Their best event with a lot of depth. As you look at their lineup, Demi Paz to lead off, Rihanna Barrett to anchor, a junior and a freshman here in rotation two.
Now, generally in a lineup, a coach is going to construct that lineup so that with each passing gymnast, their scores are going to go up. And they're going to usually start with someone they feel a lot of confidence in and that they know that is going to hit and start off the event on a really positive note and end on their star.
Let's hear from Claire Collins of Ball State before rotation two.
Our routines need to have perfect handstands, big air in the release moves, and a stuck dismount. It's important to keep perfect rhythm throughout our routine in order to look like we're flying. Chirp, chirp.
Brooklyn, that was your event when you were here competing for Ball State. Certainly your strongest of the four.
Yes, I loved competing on the bars, and I believe I only didn't at one meet due to an ankle injury. So that was that's a heart for me. I love the bars, I love to watch the bars, and I love to see the Cardinals compete on the bars, as well as all the other teams here today. In the warm-ups, they've all looked really sharp.
Certainly a difficult event.
For our next rotation, Ball State will begin on the bars, Eastern Michigan will be on the beam, and Illinois State
Katie Honorman starting the Cardinals off. Katie is known for her beautiful lines on the bars.
Celine Blue, she's a nice, consistent competitor. That's why they lead, does Ball State with.
Absolutely. She's going to have her most difficult release move right here at the end of the routine, which the judges love to see. Legs come apart there in the ginger, but a really great dismount there from Katie. Great start for the Cardinals.
Early on this week, we were talking to Coach Salim, the Ball State Gymnastics head coach, and she said that bars is, you know, where they can improve. However, Katie Honorman, she has really been perfecting knee bends, elbow bends, stuff like that. So here in this routine, it looks like she's been working towards the better knee bends, better elbow bends, so on and so forth.
Absolutely.
This is Ebyer of Eastern Michigan on the beam, the sister to Sarah.
Little smile at the judges there. They love to see that. They love to see presence on the beam, confidence. A one-handed back handspring into a layout. Now that's a really difficult series, which actually her sister does the same one. Must run in the family. Another smile at the judges. The Ebyer sisters are really known for their presence, not only on the beam, but also on the floor and any event that they're on. The judges know they're there. They know that they're having fun, and they know that they're really confident. Wow, a round off double full is her dismount, and she looks excited about that routine.
Kimberly Ebyer being the only senior for Eastern Michigan, she's had to, you know, step up, be a big leader this year, and Coach Santos said she's really been able to overcome execution problems this year and just, you know, compete just like she did on the beam.
A real challenge for gymnasts is competing what they practice. Every day in practice, they're in there cranking out routines, but it's a completely different story when you're in front of a crowd, have judges watching your every move. It's very nerve-wracking, and so these coaches are going to try to get that experience in on their gymnasts and really improve every move that they can make. Every tenth counts in a tri meet like this.
Back to the bars of Ball State with Miranda Keel. Honor Man started off with a 9.5. Keel coming off a 9.250 performance on Friday at Illinois State. A busy weekend for Ball State and Illinois State.
Now, Miranda Keel had been Freshman of the Year when she was a freshman. She's currently a junior. And she's had some really significant injuries to overcome since then. She was a breakout freshman that was the one to watch when she that year. She was also a captain as a sophomore. So not only a great gymnast, but a leader on the team. Salute the judges.
Miss Keel has really tried to work on just the little details in her bar routines. Hopefully within the months, start to see those small deductions go down.
Your little ankle's coming apart. Oh. Now, when a gymnast is off, even just a little bit in the handstands, that's hard to come back from. Each angle counts when they're doing difficult release moves like that. But she brings it back.
Another look at it. On the dismount.
Next on the beam for Eastern Michigan is Megan Holtgren.
Megan Holtgren on the beam for Eastern Michigan out of Rockford, Illinois, just outside of Chicago.
A beautiful press handstand there is her mount. That's a really uncommon mount to see in college gymnastics. She's really showing the judges her strength.
An event where Eastern Michigan 11th in the country.
Next on the floor for Illinois State.
That's an incredible feat for a MAC school. That's a really solid there on that backhand spring back layout. Split jump, sheep jump. That's a difficult jump as you're taking your eyes off the beam and landing blind. That's when a gymnast really trusts that the beam is right where she left it.
The dismount?
Full and a half dismount. Not quite a stick, but very close.
Megan Holtgren only competed beam through her last junior and senior years of high school. Early on in high school, she said she competed on bars as well. So beam is her strong suit. She's obviously been able to perfect some of her moves and, you know, try and get that dismount to the best she can possibly get it.
That goes back to high school, was the 2014 state champion on beam in Illinois. Back over to bars with Ball State.
Another fall for the Cardinals. That means they're going to have to count a fall on this event.
This is Madison Howell.
Madison Howell's first competition was on Friday, so she is a freshman. She's probably a little bit nervous right now, I can only imagine, but her first competition was two days ago against Illinois State in Lindenwood.
A two-meet weekend is really difficult for a gymnast as it takes a lot of energy out of you. They gotta really take care of their bodies.
In that meet on Friday, a score on the bars of 9.75.
A great score.
Especially for your first.
Missed her hands there a little bit on that shoot over. Tapped her feet. To tap your feet, it's about a 3/10 deduction. But a really great dismount there to finish it off. Madison was the 3-time back-to-back state champion when she was in high school. So she was a great recruit for the Cardinals.
Valentin on beam for Eastern Michigan. One of her stronger events, second in the MAC on beam.
Next on the beam for Eastern Michigan is Kendall Valentin.
Smiling at the judges there. And a really difficult move there to start out just within her dance. A triple flight series there, a back handspring layout. That's an extremely difficult series that she gets a lot of bonus for connecting three flight elements. Also a strug, that is worth an E. So that right there is a 10th bonus for the Eagles.
Valentin last year was hampered by an ankle injury.
And a great gainer full dismount.
Valentin competing all around today for Eastern Michigan. She said she knows she has to manage a really big workload, but she's ready for it, ready to compete. You know, she's just accepting the challenge and coming out here full force.
This is Durkak of Ball State on the bars.
Now, Angela Durkak competes a pack salto full, and she's the only one in the MAC to do this skill.
When hitting, Coach Celine believes she could have one of the best routines on the bars in college gymnastics.
Absolutely. She is known for her bars far and wide.
She's fourth on the bars for Ball State here in rotation two.
Now, Angela is coming back from an ACL tear, so dismounts like that are really difficult for Angela, coming down on both of her legs like that. It's easy to overlook the kind of force that is coming down on a leg, because she seems to have mastered it. She's getting right back out there. That takes a lot of hard work in the training room as well as in the weight room.
Back over to Beam with Eastern Michigan and Rachel Slocum, MAC Specialist of the Week, January 12th.
Some last minute pointers from their Beam coach.
Slocum was a 2015 academic All-American, one of several for this Eastern Michigan team. One of their goals coming in with Coach Santos last season as Jess's second year was really to change the culture academically on the program.
Going back to last year, Slocum, she competed in every single meet. Her first year, so her freshman year as an Eagle, she competed somewhere in, you know, either floor or beam, somehow, some way in every single meet her first year.
Holmgren on the beam for Eastern Michigan with a 9.825.
That's a score that could easily place today.
She went second here on rotation two, right behind E. Byer.
Getting some nerves out there before she goes. Got her team cheering her on as well.
And long layouts like this, Brooklyn, psychologically, does it do anything to you?
It does, especially on an event like the beam. While you're standing there waiting for the judges to be ready to salute you, you just have time there to think, which is why a teammate or a coach will come over and talk you through it. But if you're just standing there on your own, that's a hard thing to do and get your mind ready to go, but also not psych yourself out. That's why it's really important to have a teammate or a coach there to talk you through it. Got Jordan Penny singing, too. A little bobble there on her full turn. That's a required skill in all beam routines in the NCAA. A back handspring gainer layout step out. We'll see if the judges give her connection for that. Looked like she hesitated there. And a standing layout step out there as well. High difficulty in this beam routine.
Next on the floor for Illinois State is Tennessee Chai.
handoff, double full to a great dismount. The judges love to see a gymnast react that way after they land.
One more look by our terrific camera crew. On bars is Penny from Aurora, Illinois. Fifth in rotation three, rather in two.
A Pike Jaeger there into a shoot over, connecting two really difficult release moves. She doesn't go for her dismount due to an angle in her giant full. Now that's something in practice that Coach Saleem and Coach Wolford really try to get the Cardinals to do, to go for their element even when their giant or their pirouettes are not perfect. That's a third fall for the Cardinals. Great cast there. Giant full into a double tuck, stuck. A great dismount.
Next on the beam for Eastern Michigan.
A sophomore from Aurora, Illinois, just 30 minutes west of Chicago.
Now, even after a routine that was not perfect, the judges love to see a stuck dismount because they know how much that takes.
This is Dancy Cha of Illinois State on the floor. Competing fourth on the floor for Illinois State.
Beautiful double tuck there. She got her jumps out of the way pretty early with a switch side straddle full. That full turn she also did on the beam. Shows off her flexibility. Double pike last pass didn't go out.
Next on the bars,
that's a very difficult last pass to end on. The judges love to see that. The difficulty distributed throughout the routine.
That was Cha, the senior from Milwaukee for Illinois State. Beckler, the anchor on the bars for Ball State. Junior out of Cincinnati. Final bar routine that could potentially be scored here in rotation two for Ball State.
Beautiful cast there from Beckler. Giant full double tuck. Didn't stick the dismount, but a great routine from Beckler. Now, Kayla Beckler is arguably the most naturally talented on the team. She has beautiful gymnastics on all the events that she trains.
Katie Conran, the anchor on beam for Eastern Michigan, has already competed on bars as well in the anchor spot too.
You can just tell she is really confident in this routine based on the look on her face. Beautiful series of back handspring layout step out. Third of the same jump from the Eagles. It looks like a sheep jump is a favorite. side aerial back full into a stuck dismount. That's a great routine for the Eagles.
Coach Santos said, Katie Conrad always just jumps right up on that beam. Like he said, she got up there with confidence. She's always positive and she's ready to go. And that's exactly what you want from a gymnast, especially on the beam.
Yes.
This is Hacker on the bars for Ball State in an exhibition routine. Will not count on scores, but an opportunity for the coaches to reevaluate things moving forward.
A little ankle separation here in her first series. Looks like she's a little bit off on her angles, but pulling it through just the same. Now Hacker is coming back from a torn ACL as well. And she had actually torn not the same ACL back in club gymnastics when she was in high school. So she has a replaced ACL in both knees. A dismount like that is really impressive from her.
Through rotation two here in Worthen Arena, an impressive outing on the beam by Eastern. Good job, everyone, on that second rotation. That was really, I like, started clicking a little. Feel free to jump in there more with just anything you have.
What?
Feel free to jump in even more with just even notes that you have. An impressive outing by Eastern Michigan in rotation two on the beam. Morgan Landis caught up with the head coach of Illinois State earlier.
Thanks, Tyler. Coach, you've had a few meets early on this season. How have you kind of grown as a team to now?
We progressively have gotten better each meet, but not the leaps and bounds that we're hoping to have. We just need to be a little more consistent on balance beam and the uneven bars. Vault and floor have been fine, but those two events, we've been struggling with consistency.
Meredith LaRoche, competing all around for you today. What are you expecting from her? How big of an asset has she been for your program?
You know, she's a freshman and she's a very powerful gymnast. Unfortunately, her ankle's a little sore today, so we're going to have to water her down a little bit on floor. But we're still hoping that she's going to be able to compete the all-around, but we have backups just in case. Her ankle's just been getting progressively worse, and it's the second meet this weekend, and we don't want to push it too much with her.
All right, Coach, thank you so much for your time, and good luck in today's try meet.
Okay, thank you so much.
Bob Conkling, the head coach of Illinois State, a graduate of Indiana Wesleyan, just north of Muncie and Ball State University, where his team competes today in the tri-meet with Eastern Michigan and Ball State. Through two rotations, we look back at rotation two with Illinois State on the floor.
This well as a double pike to end a routine. Judges love to see difficulty right there at the end.
Eastern Michigan went on the bars in rotation to 11th in the country currently. A strong event for them and showed why they're in rotation too.
The double twisting poles there as dismounts, as well as three sheep jumps, blind landing jumps, and triple flight series. A lot of confidence from the Eagles in their beam. That stuck out today a lot.
Rotation two, Ball State on the bars.
Bars was not the Cardinals' strong suit today, but they still had a lot of great landings there. We'll be eager to see if the Cardinals can bring it back mentally here for their third event on the beam. It's difficult to follow up a rough event, especially on the beam, when confidence is a little shaken, but the Cardinals are known for being able to do that.
This is the new home of Ball State Gymnastics. Used to compete in the recreational center on campus at Ball State University. This year, switching inside of Wortham Arena, typically used for basketball games, volleyball, among other athletic events. This is Coach Salim of Ball State.
Things, which is there's more room on the competition floor and the video boards and be able to make it a complete event so that the athletes are in this big arena where it comes out and they really feel like that they're in a college atmosphere.
It kind of gives it like more of a meet feel, I guess. So it's more exciting, more energy. But it is definitely a great experience just being in that big thing and getting ready for MAC because we're hosting MAC here. So it's a great experience to get ready for it.
And having around 900 people there was great. I'd like to double that so that we have that same competitive advantage with the energy and the atmosphere from the fans.
Just have to work that much harder, cheer that much louder, but it's been awesome. I've loved it.
Brooklyn, during your career, the home facility for Ball State Gymnastics, the Julian Gora Recreational Center, now in Wortham Arena. You did compete in here during your college career. What's the difference between the two facilities?
Well, the two are actually very different. In the Julian Gora Recreational Center, the fans are right there next to you, and it would fill up due to people just walking by and wanting to stay for the event once they see the excitement. Here in Wortham, people aren't normally just strolling through. However, they come here with intent. They come here to watch a gymnastics meet. They get here on time, and they're ready to go. People are able to hand them the chirp that you can see out there in the stands, and it looks like the Cardinals are really owning their new video boards.
Certainly an impressive facility for Ball State Gymnastics and Wortham Arena as we look back at rotation two and the results with Ball State on the bars. A team score of 47.675 on the bars and top routines from Angela Dirtkak and Kayla Becker. Eastern Michigan also competed on the beam. Certainly their strongest event, a 49.150 as a team, a new season high for Eastern Michigan, 11th in the country.
That's an incredible score for the Eagles and what they are certainly striving for at each meet on the beam. A 49 or above is exactly what every NCAA team is wanting.
You know, we talked a little bit about beam results and what, you know, each team really wants to shoot for, and a 9.75 would be great for each team. And there was only one gymnast on Eastern Michigan who got below that, so, and she still got a 9.65. So excellent beam routines from each gymnast on Eastern Michigan.
Absolutely, and that consistency is exactly what Coach Santos wants from his ladies on the beam. He wants there to be no bad score to drop. When a 9.65 is the score that's dropped, that means every score above it was really great, and they're happy to count those scores.
It was the first time of a plus 49 on the beam this year for Eastern Michigan. Ball State currently through two rotations, a score of 95.875 in their last home meet against Towson. Through two rotations, a 96.75.
Having to count falls on bars was certainly not ideal for the Cardinals, but it's not something they can't overcome either. They're certainly hoping to match or even beat Eastern's beam score today.
4-minute touch period before rotation three, halfway through today's tri-meet with Ball State, Eastern Michigan, and Illinois State. Rotation three with Ball State. All three, rather, working in an Olympic order. Ball State in the beam, Eastern Michigan the floor, and Illinois State the vault.
That's Tanasia Christian warming up there on the beam.
Today's practice is from 2:30 to 5. I'm Sarah Ebiter, and this is a day in my life.
Ball State just getting through the beams there on rotation two. Brooklyn, that your strongest event when you were here for Ball State, as we take a look back at a couple of highlights when you were here for Ball State.
Oh, dear. Here we go.
I'm sure it brings back a few memories here and there. There, of course, in the recreational center.
Absolutely. These were the best years of my life on this team. Here at Ball State, it was the greatest experience of my life. I'd do it over again in a heartbeat if I could.
Your favorite part about college gymnastics?
Being able to compete in front of thousands of people.
Not singing to the music like you were there in the
Well, that's a given. That's just part of the game.
Go Cards.
It's been difficult not to do that today, actually, with a microphone.
I mean, you can sing if you want.
Dance a little bit.
If that's what the people want, that's what they'll get.
I'm sure we'll expect that during the floor routine.
Okay. I can deliver.
This rotation, Ball State will be on the beam. Eastern Michigan will be on the floor.
One of the gymnasts to watch today on the balance beam from Ball State is going to be sophomore Bailey Bell. She was kind of the breakout freshman on the beam last year, taking the spot of Samantha Santos, an alumni today who tore her Achilles last year. She stepped up for the Cardinals in a way that I know Coach Salim really appreciated. She's getting a pep talk at the moment from Miranda Keel, a junior.
Speaking of Coach Salim, she was talking about Bailey Bell earlier on this week. She said, you know, she gets out there, gets on the beam. She's a no-nonsense kind of girl and sets the tone for the rest of the team.
Absolutely, and that's her job as the first person on the event, is to set the tone.
During rotation two, Illinois State on the floor as you look at their results. On your screen, a top performance by Dancy Shaw, as expected. As we begin rotation three with Ball State on the beam, Bailey Bell, the aforementioned Bailey, in the leadoff for Ball State.
Bailey didn't make her back handspring back layout, very uncommon for her. A beautiful full turn. Confidence a little shaken for Bailey at the moment.
As a state champion on the beam back in high school in 2014.
Now that's a score that the Cardinals generally count on is from Bailey Bell. So we'll see if they can bring it back.
The only event that Bell will compete in. And the beam for Ball State. Over on floor with Eastern Michigan, Kirsten Gendron, the Birch Run, Michigan.
First on the floor for Eastern Michigan will be Kirsten Gendron.
Certainly the favorite event from the crowd.
A great first pass there for the Eagles. A front one and a half, back layout, step out. She has excellent form in not only her passes, but also in her jumps, which is rare for some gymnasts and something that the judges are really looking for. Very powerful choreography as well.
Ball
easy to overlook how much endurance the floor routine takes, especially after a powerful first pass. A strong front tumbler there with a front full front layout. Back one and a half, punch front. A great first routine there for the Eagles.
That's Gendron on the floor for Eastern Michigan, a 2012 level 10 state champion on the floor. Here rotation three, this is Ball State on beam with their second, Sarah Ebyer.
Now Sarah is one of the only ladies here today to do that, connect a jump to her full turn.
Second of three events today for Ebyer, competed earlier on the vault. He'll compete on the floor in rotation four.
Didn't quite make that series. It's the exact same series that her sister Kimberly competed earlier this afternoon. With a second fall there for the Cardinals, it means they will be counting a fall on beam today. A gainer full, stuck landing. You can see the Cardinals' spirit falling a little bit here today. That's difficult not to happen after two rocky events.
Your rotation three, Illinois State on the vault, where Ball State started.
A Yurchenko layout.
Back onto the floor we go. Katie Conrad, second in the rotation for Eastern Michigan.
Starting off this floor routine exactly the way she did on the beam, with excellent confidence and pristine presentation for the audience. Front one and a half, back layout step out, just like her teammate before her. Rotated there in her back one and a half punch front. Didn't go out of bounds. Judges, and they seem to be smiling right back at her. A great routine for Katie.
Next on the beam for Ball State is Sydney.
A five from Conrad as she runs off after her floor routine, competing all around today.
A very impressive feat.
Back on beam with Ball State.
back handspring back layout. Performs very well. She was the balance beam state champion when she was in high school. And a round off double tuck off the beam. She's the only one for the Cardinals who has this dismount, a very impressive dismount. Takes a step backwards out of it. But the judges love to see an ending like that, a really powerful ending.
McEachern, a junior for Eastern Michigan, on the floor. Career high of 9.85.
The Eagles all seem to have great presentation and great choreography in their floor routines today. Starting her routine off with a near perfect double pike. For her second pass. Got her teammates helping her out in this routine. With a double tuck, a really difficult last pass. But she made it look easy.
Now on the beam for Ball State.
Earlier on this week, Coach Jay Santos was talking about how floor is the weakest of their four events and it needs the most work, but it could either be, you know, the make or break it event. And right now it seems to be making it for them.
Yeah, I don't see weakness from them on the floor today.
Back on beam, Ball State with Kayla Beckler, a junior out of Cincinnati.
Perfect backhand spring back layout there from Kayla Beckler. Front aerial beat jump. Showing off her flexibility there with a switch leap straddle jump. And a full and a half dismount. Every tenth for the Cardinal today is going to count. And Kayla Beckler did not disappoint.
Led the team last year when Ball State and Eastern Michigan met up with a 9.8. On the beam did Beckler. This is Valentin of Eastern Michigan.
Is Kendall Valentin.
Fourth for Eastern Michigan on the floor in rotation three.
Already starting her routine off with a smile. A
front 1.5. And a really strong jump series there too. For her middle pass. The Eagles seem to be really strong with their front tumbling this season. And great choreography.
Akron previously on the floor for Eastern Michigan, a 9.750 as we watch Valentin.
A great routine from Valentin.
Floor is Valentin's life. I don't really know what the word is, but it's her base most worked on. She's competed more in vault, bars, and beam than she has floor, and she came out here and made it look like she's been doing it.
Absolutely.
Just like she's done the other three events.
Absolutely.
Jordan Penny on beam for Ball State.
Penny is a fierce competitor. The Cardinals need that to come out today on beam.
The 9.625 on Friday at Illinois State did Penny.
Great backhand spring back layout there. In practice, Penny wears a back brace for her injury, but in competition, she chooses not to. And a really great full and a half dismount. Cardinals are thrilled with that beam routine.
Even though Kayla Becker was the fourth gymnast for the Cardinals to compete on beam, she really came out kind of set the tone for the bottom half of the balance beam competitors for Ball State.
Absolutely. Any given gymnast does not have to be the first, can be the one to really set the tone for the rest of the meet. It only takes one great routine to put them right back on track.
We've seen Kimberly Ebyer several times so far today for Eastern Michigan. This is her floor routine with several family members in attendance tonight. The two sisters of Eastern and Ball State colliding today.
Getting loose before her floor routine. Ready to really give the audience something to watch.
Both of the Ebyer sisters, alumni of the Reinsch Gymnastics Academy. 2 years apart between Kimberly and Sarah, Eastern Michigan and Ball State respectively. This is Kimberly.
Front double full, a really difficult pass. Once again showing the Eastern Michigan Eagles' strength in the front tumbling. A whip double full, you don't see those very often in college gymnastics. Showing a lot of diversity in her routine. Both Ebyer sisters demonstrating incredible choreography and incredible presence, bringing smiles to the judges' faces. Thank you. an incredible routine for Kimberly Ebyer.
You know, Eastern Michigan has been ranked the last 2 weeks in a row prior to this week. They were 20th 2 weeks ago, 21st last week. And through these first three rotations, I can really see why they are ranked.
Absolutely. Danasia Christian here on the beam.
Ball State's top gymnast.
A beautiful backhand spring layout. Christian looks really determined in this routine, determined to put her team where she knows they can be. This is an incredible acro series she has here. A beat jump punch front with no run, no steps into it, shows her sheer power there on the beam. You can do that.
Kenny with a 9.725 on beam. The routine right before Christian in the anchor spot for Ball State.
A front full. Did not disappoint for the Cardinals today, Danasia Christian.
Christian, the anchor for Ball State on the beam, the vault as well, the floor too. For Ball State has really worked on her beam exercise.
I feel like I've done a better job, I guess I would say, like taking on that role. Whereas normally in past years, I'll kind of like be in the background doing my own thing and join. I was like, well, you need to like, okay. Well, so I think I've done a better job just kind of stepping up and actually helping my teammates this year.
Danasia Christian has really stepped up this year in the gym, just saying this is the level of expectation and we're not going to settle for less.
I came to college not thinking that I was going to touch a beam. If I stayed on the beam in club, then it was a good day. So the fact that I'm like in lineup and being more consistent on beam is kind of a big deal.
Danasia Christian, the top gymnast for Ball State, is a gymnast of the week in the Mid-American Conference, January 19th, third time in her career. An impressive start to her senior season.
Absolutely. Christian is coming into this season with such force. She is not disappointing the Cardinals thus far. She already has an individual title on each of the three events she starts on, which is incredibly rare for college gymnastics this early to already have a win on each of the three events you start on. Danasia Christian, a force to be reckoned with in the Mid-American Conference. Getting ready to watch Jackie Duffy, a sophomore who also serves as a captain. She's a leader on this team and has a routine ready on most events so that if the Cardinals need someone to go in, she is ready.
Coach Salim watches on as the exhibition for Ball State on the beam prepares. Danasia Christian on the beam with a 9.725 for Ball State. Christian at a 9.850 and a team high on Friday against Illinois State in Normal, Illinois. Final beam routine for Ball State here in rotation three with Jackie Duffy.
Now Jackie's in a position to really prove herself to try and get in this lineup for the next couple of meets.
How much stock Brooke would have put in exhibition routine?
A lot for the coaches. They're watching to see how she handles this after the team has not set her up very well. And that's an incredible series there, a front toss into a back layout. The coaches are really watching to see how she handles this stress and is able to perform based on her performance in the gym. And Jackie Duffy looks very confident today. She's singing along to her music there on the beam. A little bobble there on her full turn. She's not going to let that get in her way. stuck front full dismount. The team looks thrilled with that performance, as well as Jackie Duffy.
The sophomore out of Ohio, Ball State in the exhibition of the beam with one more look at it on the dismount.
A great landing.
Little side note about Jackie Duffy, she has an extremely athletic family. Her mother played softball for Penn State, father played football for Penn State, and then was drafted into the NFL. So really athletic family for Duffy.
This is the exhibition routine for Eastern Michigan on the floor. Megan Marino.
One of the only Eagles to start out with a back pass today, a back double pike.
Not compete last year as a freshman. This is her sophomore season. Take a look at the score alerts. Slocum with a 9.85 on floor.
It's an incredible score.
The anchor for Eastern Michigan here in rotation three.
Strong routine there for the Eagles in exhibition. Looks like they have a lot of depth on this event.
Like we said before, you know, Coach Santos for Eastern Michigan, you know, mentioned it was either make it or break it, and I think his gymnasts came out and said, you know, we're not going to let us break it today. They came out wholeheartedly and put everything into their floor routines.
Absolutely. The Eagles brought their A game today.
After rotation three, Eastern Michigan with the lead, 146.525. Ball State in second, Illinois State in third, and today's tri-meet in Worthen Arena. Rotation four is next, where Ball State will finish on the floor. Back in 60. We're going to come out and we're going to go highlights and scores from rotation three, guys. And then we're going to bounce around a little bit. And I'm going to ask you guys about the strengths of finishing on the floor at home as your last event. Mm-hmm. Both of you guys, you know, feel free to talk as much as possible. And then we're going to send it to Shelby Arms talking about the floor.
Okay.
So it's time to get up off your feet and make some noise.
through three rotations in Worthen Arena in today's try meet. Eastern Michigan, Ball State, and Illinois State respectively in scores after the three rotations. In rotation three, Illinois State on the vault.
It looks like they had a pretty strong lineup there with a Yurchenko full and a Yurchenko layout.
Their best two routines on the rotation three, Eastern Michigan on the floor, the event that Santos felt as though could see the most work in weeks to come.
We did not see that today. They came out with an incredible floor lineup, a lot of front tumbling, which you won't see as much of for the Cardinals.
And then on beam, Ball State in rotation three.
The Cardinals really came back after two shaky routines and brought it back there at the end, stapled by Denasia Christian.
That was rotation three for Illinois State on the vault, Eastern Michigan on the floor, and Ball State on the beam. It's been an impressive showing so far, especially from Eastern Michigan.
Absolutely. The Eastern Michigan Eagles are going to be hard to catch here on this last event.
You know, Coach Santos was talking about them a little bit, just saying, you know, it's hard to stop once they get the momentum going.
Absolutely.
In rotation three, the beam results for Ball State with a team score of 48.05. And the top performance from the back half of the lineup with Beckler, Penny, and Christian. Eastern Michigan and rotation three was on the floor with Rachel Slocum as the anchor for Eastern Michigan, Kirsten Gendron.
Ending on the floor for the Cardinals is a great place for them to be ending, which is where the home team will always end. The Cardinals have impressive lineups here today.
Floor results from Eastern Michigan. Slocum on the anchor, as we talked, 9.85. And Illinois State as well on the vault in rotation three, the Redbirds of the Midwest Independent Conference. Last year a 2-7 team with a 47.45 as a team in rotation three on the vault. A top score from Sarah Fisher, their anchor, 9.75. That was rotation three. Ball State prepares for the final rotation in today's try meet with the floor. Shelby Arms prepares us for it.
Shelby Arms is a gymnast.
You're fine.
Each routine is as unique as the gymnast performing it.
Shelby Arms is a gymnast on the floor who really has made a huge comeback. She started here for the Cardinals as not the strongest floor worker. She was there, she was ready with a routine, but she has come out this year with incredible scores after lots of hard work and perfection. She has an extremely difficult routine for the Cardinals, one of the most difficult in the lineup.
Arms was a floor champion in the state of Indiana in high school as a freshman. From Jeffersonville, Indiana, down towards Louisville, Kentucky.
Shelby Arms going to be competing in the floor for Ball State. She did get her career high on floor last year against Eastern Michigan with a 9.80. So hopefully she can pull that through here for the Cardinals.
Absolutely. Coach Salim is really banking on these floor girls coming out strong.
Rotation four features Ball State on the floor. With Eastern Michigan on the vault, Illinois State on the bars as Ball State's floor lineup lead off with a freshman Finke, anchored by the two-time Mid-American Conference floor champion, Denasia Christian, in her senior season for Ball State.
Coach Salim talked a little bit about Denisha Christian, why she's the anchor, and she just basically said, you know, she's the anchor on the floor because she's the most powerful. She brings it, you know, she just brings it to the table, puts it out there, and she's our best gymnast on the floor.
When Denisha Christian takes the floor, the rest of the arena stops. They watch, they know who's on the floor, and they know that it's the defending MAC champion. That is no small feat, and the entire audience, as well as the other teams, are going to be watching. She commands attention on this event.
The event in rotation four that's really coming on strong for Eastern Michigan. The vault. Santos feels as though there's still a lot of improvements that need to be made, but they've made some good strides on the last month on their power on vault, and they started to develop a little bit of depth. And Illinois State, still working in Olympic order, finishes up on bars. The first Mid-American Conference meet for Ball State this season. Projected to finish seventh in the MAC, finished last year tied for sixth in the MAC championships. Eastern Michigan projected to finish third behind the usual powerhouses, Central Michigan and Kent State. They finished fourth last season.
Both the Cardinals and the Eagles are going to be working hard this season to overcome those projections, to beat the way that the MAC has projected that they're going to end. All teams are going to be after Kent State and Eastern Michigan, as well as Central Michigan.
Eastern really exploded onto the scene last year in Santos' first season, the 2015 MAC Coach of the Year. With a record of 13-5, tying the record for most regular season wins. Several alums for Ball State in attendance today with Alumni Day. With some prominent alums and a former All-American for Ball State. Of course, Brooklyn Schumacher, not mentioned on that list on the telecast today. But always good to see some support from alumni.
Absolutely. Lots of alumni came out today and they're in the stands supporting. Many of which are not listed. Juliana Booth and Kayla Beckler showing some love.
Sarah Fisher leads off for Illinois State on the bars. Fisher, a senior.
Some ankle separation there from Fisher. Not quite hitting her casts.
First on the floor for Ball State is Sydney Finke.
This is Fisher on the bars.
A double layout dismount. The most difficult element in her routine is there at the end. Got Sydney Finke on the floor.
In the leadoff spot out of Indianapolis, Indiana. Just a freshman competing on floor for Ball State.
Salim mentioned she has really high level tumbling, and that's why they start out with Sydney Finke on the floor.
Absolutely, a front double full into a punch front. Strong choreography there. Another front pass there for Finke into a back layout step out.
Thank you.
Lightning with an incredible double pike went out of bounds. That'll be a 10th deduction for Finke. But still an extremely strong routine to start off with.
Finke, a freshman, a three-time state champion, as Ebyer for Eastern Michigan leads off in rotation four on the vault.
A Yurchenko half with a couple of steps there at the end. Each of those steps will be a full 10th deduction for Ebyer.
We talked a little bit earlier about how Eastern Michigan's made a lot of improvements just on the vault in this month, and one of those is Jay Santos was telling us he really wants to try and control the landings a little bit more. As you saw there, that one needed controlled, and you know, they're working on it. It's a work in progress for the Eagles.
Absolutely, and it's very early in the season.
Eastern Michigan has tried to put it, as Morgan mentioned, an emphasis on the landings, landing with the chest down, something they try to stray away from. Menzioni, a freshman, second up on the floor for Ball State here in rotation floor, in rotation four. A 9.575 on the floor on Friday at Illinois State.
Menzioni.
This is a brand new routine for Kayla Menzioni, and she looks extremely confident with it thus far. A double pike first pass. Coach Salim has said that in the gym she's working on a full twisting double back, which is the same pass that Denasia Christian opens up with. That would make two for the Cardinals. Front layout. Incredible double back tuck. Not surprising to see such an incredible routine from Menzioni as a national qualifier in 2013 and 15.
Next on vault for Eastern Michigan is Julia Schwartz.
One more look at Menzioni's floor routine. Just a freshman for Ball State. Out of Downers Grove, Illinois. A true freshman, an impressive showing against Towson.
Absolutely.
And once Denasia Christian leaves, potentially one of the next big gymnasts for Ball State.
Absolutely. Menzioni has that potential as she is training all four events. And not just training them, but she has impressive difficulty on all of the events. She has the potential to start and medal on all four, as you just saw in her floor routine.
Eastern Michigan on vault in the final rotation here in today's try meet.
A Yurchenko full with a pretty good landing. Going to have a couple of deductions there for a low chest.
That's Schwartz for Eastern Michigan.
Shelby Arms preparing for a floor routine.
Shelby Arms, who we heard from right before the start of rotation four. With Ball State on the floor, a 9.775 on Friday on the floor.
Like I mentioned before, Shelby Arms, career high against Eastern Michigan last year on the floor, 9.80. Hopefully she can bring that same intensity and come out here and knock out another floor routine for the Cardinals.
Absolutely, and her warm-up showed that. She had a really great warm-up there with great landings and clean form.
And her floor routine against Eastern Michigan led Ball State to a win. Their only event they won against Eastern Michigan last year with 48.875 as a team.
Next on the floor for Ball State is Shelby Arms.
This is a brand new routine for Shelby. Look at that smile, giving the judges and the audience something to watch. A 2.5 punch front, opening up with very high difficulty, but excellent execution. That jump series Shelby has worked very hard to complete. Normally an Achilles heel for her.
Preceded by a 9.775 by Menziona.
A great score. A front double full, which was the opening pass for many of the Eagles. But for Shelby, she can do that in the middle of her routine to follow up. The Cardinals are known for their high difficulty level on the floor. They're not afraid to put it out there. A great routine from Shelby Arms.
So far, so good on the floor for the Cardinals.
Absolutely. Which is just what the Cardinals need at the end of this meet.
McEachern back on the vault for Eastern Michigan.
With a Yurchenko full. A little bit of a low chest there again. That'll be a little bit of a deduction.
McEachern, a primary contributor on vault and floor last season as a sophomore for Eastern Michigan and Jay Santos' crew.
We have Claire Collins receiving a little bit of a pep talk from Coach Saleem. Claire Collins is known for her impressive performance, and now she's getting a pep talk from the floor queen herself, Denasia Christian.
Ball State's upcoming schedule, with this being their first Mid-American Conference meet with Eastern Michigan. The end of the month in January at Central Michigan, back on the road at the start of February as the MAC schedule really starts to take full prominence here for Ball State, gearing up for their MAC championships this year. And they meet where they finished tied for sixth last season. Projected to finish seventh. With Claire Collins on the floor, rotation four, the fourth gymnast. For Ball State
is Claire Collins.
Wow, a punch front, round up back handspring double pike. 1.5 for her middle pass. Really showing the diversity in the routine that she can not only front tumble, but she can also back tumble. Touches her hands there on that double back tuck. That'll be a 5/10 deduction.
Next on the ball for Eastern Michigan is
now that would have been a great score from Claire Collins.
This is Conrad on the vault for Eastern Michigan. Competing all around.
Doesn't quite make it, doesn't get her toes under her. Looks like she was really trying to have her chest up, but pulled her chest up before her feet hit the ground.
I will say one thing about Katie Conrad is in every rotation today, she's really come out and just had that confidence look at the beginning. Even though she did, you know, not stick the landing there, she has really been able to come out and just have so much confidence in herself.
Absolutely. She was going for a stick there and had her chest up a little bit too soon.
Here in rotation for Illinois State, competing on the bars, it's Moeller.
Stalder there into a ginger and connected to a shoot over. A lot of difficulty right there at the beginning of her routine.
Coach Bob Conkling for Illinois State said, you know, Amanda Moeller is the best bar person by far on our team. She's a little inconsistent at times, but usually ends super well.
Absolutely, with that stuck dismount.
All right, Cardinal fans, we really need you on this one. It's time to get loud.
On the back half of Ball State's floor routines.
Sarah Ebyer getting ready to go. Sarah has kept the same choreography and music for her floor routine 3 years. Which is uncommon, but she has incredible choreography that the judges as well as the audience love, so there's no reason for her to change it.
Is the goal to perfect it and keep the same routine, or do you try to change it every year?
She certainly has perfected it, but for some they want to change it up, for some they want to keep it consistent.
This is Ebyer from Whiteland.
Double pike with a perfect landing. And a beautiful jump series as well. Front 1.5, back layout, step out for her middle pass. A lot of difficulty in this routine. Front pike to end an incredible routine for Sarah Ebyer.
Next on the vault for Eastern Michigan is Rachel Slocum.
Slocum fifth on the vault for Eastern Michigan. Was the anchor on the floor.
A front pike half for her vault. That's a great vault for the Eagles and a 10-0 start value.
Slocum's had an excellent day so far. You know, she on the floor, on the vault, both routines were great.
Absolutely, and giving her coach a hug there, all of her teammates. They're absolutely thrilled with that vault.
Eastern Michigan off to a 4-1 start this season following today's try meet. January 30th, their next time in action, Northern Illinois. At home with a pair with Central Michigan. This Eastern Michigan team 13-5 last year, tying the program record for most wins in a season in the first season under Jay Santos. Well on their way off to a 4-1 start, and with a look at their upcoming schedule.
Denasia Christian, Ball State star. Now we know her family is watching today. They haven't been able to make it to a Ball State gymnastics meet, so they depend on the stream to watch their star.
The two-time MAC floor champion.
The whole room seems to have stopped with eyes on Christian. A full twisting double pike, the most difficult element seen in this meet. Denasia Christian has mastered it. A perfect front full front layout. Absolutely no deductions from that. A smile from Christian, knowing how well she is doing so far. And a perfect double tuck. Incredible routine from Denasia Christian.
Michigan is Kendall Valentin.
Denasia Christian, she only placed first four times last year on the floor, but this year with a routine looking like that, I think she'll come out with a lot more than just four first wins.
Absolutely.
Denasia Christian, the anchor on the floor for Ball State. Always a solid performer in the final event for Ball State. This is Valentin. The anchor on the vault in rotation four.
A really great pull from Valentin.
Completing rotation four with Ball State on the floor, Eastern Michigan on the vault. Illinois State competing on the bars in rotation four with Slocum. A vault of 9.90.
That's an incredible score. That it looks like the high for the meet so far. There's only 1/10 deduction for that vault.
An exhibition routine for Ball State on the floor with Kayla Beckler. Six will compete, five the top five score. Exhibition, a chance for the coaches to evaluate.
A beautiful double back tuck, favoring her leg a little bit there, an injured leg.
An all-around state champion, 2009, 2010, and 2012 from Cincinnati.
Now this is a crowd favorite coming up in her dance. Showing off that flexibility for the judges.
The score from Christian on the anchor, 9.85.
That is only 1/10 and a half deduction for an entire floor routine.
That matches her score from Friday at Illinois State.
Denasia's high career is a 9.95, only a half-tenth deduction.
That's the top score in the Mid-American Conference on floor.
A great routine from Kayla Beckler in exhibition.
Kelsey Brooks to compete as well in exhibition on the vault for Eastern Michigan. To help conclude this afternoon's tri-meet.
Yurchenko full. Almost didn't move her feet there. Had potential to stick that.
Kelsey Brooks did not compete in the 2015 season because she was injured, so she looks here to come back full force.
Absolutely. She's fighting for a lineup spot with that exhibition.
Through all four rotations inside Worthen Arena. Final scores next. Inside of Worthen Arena with Ball State finishing up on the floor. Eastern Michigan on the ball. Illinois State on the bar. You don't run down yet. Oh, you can go ahead and go down, I guess. You can go ahead and go down. Four scores. Okay, final scores and interviews next, right? Okay.
What does Kelly look like?
Kelly Tereshko? Kelly Barak. Kelly Tereshko?
No, Kelly Barak.
Kelly Barak?
Yeah. Barak. She was sitting down there the whole meet, right on the scores table.
I think Joanna's talking to her right now. I can't see her. If Joanna would move, I could see.
Through all four rotations from the tri-meet inside Worthen Arena with Ball State wrapping up on the floor, Eastern Michigan on the vault, and Illinois State on the bars, we take a look back at Illinois State's bar routines in rotation four.
Illinois State looked very strong on the bars with that double layout dismount and a full twisting double back stuck.
Eastern Michigan in rotation three on the floor.
Eastern Michigan with a lot of front tumbling and a lot of really consistent routines. Coach Santos saying it's not their strongest event, but that is not what we saw today.
Impressive outing from Eastern Michigan, and then on rotation three for Ball State, competing on the beam with Ebyer.
Having to count one fall was hard for the Cardinals, but they brought it back with really strong routines and great dismounts. Here's an example from Denasia Christian. Stuck from Jordan Penny as well.
Look back at our highlights and the bar results from Illinois State. The team score of 48.525. with the back half Ward and Muller recording team highs 9.775 apiece for Illinois State on the bars.
48-5 is a great score.
This is Eastern Michigan's vault results on the final rotation. A 9.9 from Rachel Slocum, an extremely impressive vault.
Absolutely, and a 10-0 start value with this new rule change is really valuable for the Eagles. And that 9.9 is the high of the meet.
And Ball State in rotation floor, wrapping up on the floor with Denaisha Christian on the anchor spot at a 9.850. Back-to-back meets with the same score.
Absolutely. Denaisha is known for being very consistent on that event. Her score really only varying by about a half a tenth, always up there in the 9.9, 9.85 region.
All done with rotation four. Final scores and interviews next. Eastern Michigan winners today with a team score of 195.050. Ball State finishing in second. Illinois State in third in today's dry meet with a look at our final results. Let's go down to the floor where Morgan Landis is with the head coach of Ball State.
Thank you, Tyler. Coach, floor really brought you back into this meet. You know, you had great performances. What, you know, how did you get them back into it? How did you get their intensity level to come back in and just knock out on floor?
Well, the struggle is always to make sure that you forget your mistakes and you continue forward. It helps us that floor is one of our stronger events, and those guys can go out there and they can have fun in their performances. And just reminding them, don't try too hard, just get out and relax and have fun and enjoy the performance.
So what are you looking for improvement-wise for the next meet?
Consistency. We need to be able to come out and hit our skills. Like that's the baseline of the month of January, is coming out and making sure that you're consistent and knowing that it doesn't matter what has happened, what little thing is off, I can still stay on the equipment. So we need to work on that in the gym this week.
All right, Coach, thank you so much for
your
time.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Terrific work as always, Morgan, as Ball State today finishes second in the tri-meet with Eastern Michigan and Illinois State. An opportunity to grow from here on out for Ball State.
Absolutely. A great score from the Eastern Michigan Eagles and a little bit of a disappointment for Ball State, but nothing they can't come back from this season.
Ball State finishes in second today in today's tri-meet. Today's Ball State SportsLink production was produced by Aaron Hepp and directed by J.C. Obringer. For Morgan Landis and Brooklyn Schumacher, I'm Tyler Bradfield saying so long from Muncie, where Ball State finishes second to Eastern Michigan, Illinois State in third. To watch this entire meet on replay, as well as other games in our family of ESPN networks, log on to WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app. Thanks, everybody, for watching. This has been a presentation of ESPN.